All right, so it's lunchtime here at UB, and I thought this would be a good moment to talk about the difference between a client and a server. Clients and servers are terms that we use often when we talk about exchanges that happen using protocols on the internet. Now, in some cases, computers on the internet, so clients and servers don't divide computers on the internet into two groups with no overlap. The same computer can sometimes be both a server to one other computer and a client exchanging data with another server. However, most of the computers on the internet we actually can classify into these two categories. Computers that operate almost entirely as clients, a lot of times those are the computers that we use, our laptops, our smartphones, and computers that operate as servers. A lot of times those computers don't have monitors, they're in data centers that are sort of tucked away somewhere, and those computers are just entirely devoted to meeting the needs of the clients that connect to them. So why are we out here in a food service area to talk about clients and servers? Because this is, you know, the interaction. If I went in and ordered a sandwich at one of our local, our delicious local eateries, I would be the client and the eatery is acting as a server. And that interaction kind of gives us a good starting point for talking about some of the important differences between clients and servers. So one of the first differences is, if I'm the client, I have to know where to go. I have to know where to find the server. So if there was a restaurant here on campus that was open in an undisclosed location and nobody could find, then it wouldn't have any clients. And so it's important for servers, both in real life and on the internet, to have a way for clients to find them. So for example, if I wanted to order a sandwich here, I need to know where to go, or I have to know their phone number, or maybe they have an online ordering system or something like that. But there has to be a stable way for me to find them. For example, if the restaurant I went to moved every day or it changed its phone number every day, then again, pretty soon it wouldn't have very many clients. So there has to be a way to find the server. The second thing is, the server has to be available when I need something. So if I went over to the eatery and I wanted a sandwich and they happened to be closed for that 5 minutes of the day, I'd be pretty frustrated. I might not go back there. So clients can arrive at any time, but the server, the eatery, has to be open during time the clients are going to be there. Same thing with internet services. So the servers that power, you know, your favorite search engine, those servers have to be online and ready to receive requests from clients at any time. They never know when you're going to show up and need to look for something. So if that server goes down or if that server isn't available all the time, clients will probably get frustrated and go somewhere else. So those are the two big differences between clients and servers. Servers have to have a way for clients to find them that's reliable, and servers have to be available all or almost all of the time, at least when clients need something. It's probably okay for the restaurant here to be closed in the middle of the night because it doesn't anticipate that anybody will want lunch. But if it's closed during lunchtime, that would be a problem. Specifically provide protocol services and... Oh, you're giving me a weird look. I thought someone was...